geodes. They're highly sought after for their brilliant crystals, which can sell for as high as 5 digits in dollars. Kids love searching for them to break them open, and whole markets have developed for their trade. But how have these beautiful formations come to be? Geodes, literally meaning of the earth in Greek, potentially may develop within any hollowed out stone, where all sorts of crystals could develop in the empty space under specific conditions. However, for crystals to form, the setting must be just right, and the type of geode formations and colors vary accordingly. The open spaces within the gas-containing rocks of volcanic geodes commonly create a suitable environment for an array of different crystal formations, and the same is true for cracks, crevices, and openings in layered rocks or rocks like limestone, which may be weathered or cut by water movement. In any case, it is crucial to have contact from supersaturated water or water containing more dissolved minerals than the typical maximum amount dissolved. Once such water finds its way into the empty space in a rock and is allowed to sit, voila, you have a geode. The types of crystals therefore vary widely based on the substances dissolved in the water, from black titanium to brilliant amethyst to marbled dolomite. Many of the geodes sold as decorations are actually dyed to brighten some of the common dull forms. The corresponding crystallization determines the shape of the crystals according to how the molecules of the crystal arrange themselves in what's called the lattice, and the lattice of crystals are so specific the angles between crystal formations are the same regardless of the crystal's size. Yet where can these geodes be found? Finding many different types of geodes can be as simple as picking up round rocks from lakes or streams, as the minerals inside a geode, like quartz, are often more hard and resistant to weathering than the surrounding rocks, and will many times make their way up towards the surface of flowing water. If substances like calcium carbonate, silica, or alum powder are dissolved in a solution and placed inside a jar or hollow rock, synthetic crystal growth can even be observed at home. Although geodes are not all that rare, size and composition can make large or rare geodes quite pricey, and markets have sprung up to meet demand for decorative geodes from Brazil, Uruguay, Mexico, and Namibia, among others, though certain geodes are more specific to certain regions, depending on environment. 160 million years ago in Brazil, for example, shifts from tectonic plates, floods, and lava activity formed many geode deposits. These quartz deposits were then exposed to radiation from certain surrounding materials, and today, stunning and enormous amethyst geodes are sold as decorations for thousands of dollars.